Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Stone Mountain 64. So happy to finally be bringing you guys the solution on how to get the Phantom Bow. This is an Easter egg, the end of the Phantom Operatives initiative that we started so long ago. Finally, we have closed the door on it and picked it up, or opened the door rather. Be sure to click the thumbs up button below this video. Share it out there because this is huge. Huge news, and I'm going to go through every step of it. Shout out to everybody on the Battlefield 4 subreddit, the IRC chat there, for putting this final pieces together. Yesterday we were streaming for over 6 hours. The 2 days before that, we've just been going ham streaming on my channel and tried to guess some pretty crazy stuff, but we've got the solution, so let's get into it. First thing you need to do is begin the Phantom Operatives initiative to get the assignments. Go to the leaderboards in the bottom left-hand corner. There's a little mask. Click that and enter these three passwords. First one's Bump in the Night. Some code will go through. Phase one's complete. Phase two, Epic Dream World. Phase two, complete. Phase three, this one was a bit more tricky, but eventually the number was found by crunching some numbers and doing some whole crazy stuff. You can read about it all on the Battlefield 4 subreddit or look it up elsewhere. That's the number though. I'll put all of these linked in the description as well. And then phase four, it said physical access is required. Those last three achievement or codes though, unlocked these three assignments in your assignments tab. Once you complete all three of these, you'll get from the first one, the Phantom Dog Tag, the next one, the Phantom Gun Camo, and the last one, the Phantom Camo for your character. You need to have all three of these on to go down the elevator and get the bow, so these all must be completed. You put the dog tag on the right, that Phantom one you unlocked, and then you also need a secret dog tag that's picked up on these new DLC maps. You have to run around like a madman and find these perfect rectangular boxes. You can see I found the one on Hammerhead there. You need four people, each with one of these dog tags. So yes, it does require four people to do this. And then you can go down the elevator to pick this up. Finding the dog tags is gonna be the hardest part of this. It is complete luck. You need to find these perfect rectangular boxes on all four maps. Now, I've been doing some streams of this. You can check those out to see where we found it. Extremely difficult to find, but we found tons of them over the past few days. And my absolute best advice is either two options. Go onto a dedicated no-kill map and just keep searching for it. We had a dedicated map with 20 people on it searching for these tags one at a time. Or go into random servers, hopping and only looking in known locations. Death3D compiled a great list that I'll have linked in the description down below. I'm going to go through the maps here. And that shows where all of these known locations are. Now, there are more of them, but these are possible spawn locations. Hopping around servers looking in these can be a great tactic. Just to bust some common myths, multiple can be found in one game. They spawn in random locations every time, and there's no necessary respawn timer. We've found it as quick as 5 minutes into a match, and I've heard and within 8 minutes of each other, and I've also heard people finding it within 30 seconds of each other across the map. There's also a noise that will ping across the entire map to all players regardless of location when the dog tag is found. Also, the only way to pick these dog tags up is to knife with only your basic knife, you cannot use an icicle, knife the box, the perfect rectangle, and then pick it up with E. Do not shoot it, do not explode it, or the thing will disappear forever. Also, stay until the end of the game. Do not restart the server. If you leave early, you have to wait for that server match to end, but if you restart it, you possibly can lose it. I did this, we restarted the server after I got mine, and it didn't pop up for me until the next day when I logged on. Once you've completed all of the operative assignments, got your camos, you've got your dog tag, you are set to go down. Hangar 21, the very top right-hand corner where you see all of us mashed up, is where the elevator is located. As I alluded to before, you need four tags and four people because each person can only wear one tag. Even if you find all four, you can only have one equipped. Therefore, you need four people, each with a different tag, one from each map. If you guys are looking for a final person to help you out, if you've got three or two people, hit me up on Facebook and Twitter. I'll probably be able to help you out. If not, some of the guys from my squad. I have the Hammerhead tag, but together we have it all. Also, leave in the comment section which tag you have, what console you're on, so you guys can work together to help get this, if not myself. Once all four of you are in the elevator, the light will turn on and you'll be able to descend. four times the lights will go out, essentially checking if you meet all of the criteria. Other people can be in the elevator, but they'll be killed when the lights go out. Unless you have, again, both dog tags on, one of the maps, plus the phantom dog tag, the gun camo, and the character camo. Once you successfully make it down the elevator, there's the keypad. This was what took us so long to figure out, and why I was streaming for 6.5 hours trying to solve it yesterday. We tried hundreds of combinations across thousands of submissions from Facebook, Twitch, Twitter, but we were not able to solve it. At the end of the stream, we actually predicted the correct answer, though, or at least the correct way to solve it, which was to combine the Morse code from each of the maps onto one list and then punch that in. We sent people out to find the last two maps that nobody had found yet, the Morse code, and I guess overnight it was solved, and that is just so insane. Dracfrax had decoded the 429 from Hammerhead. There's a signaling beeping boat, tugboat, that had a Morse code in Russian, which was then translated into English. Same thing with the top of Hangar 21. This was one of the first finds. If you're wearing the correct dog tag at the top of Hangar 21, you got a six-string combination. People were submitting both of these ideas to us, but it wasn't until some people on the subreddit, the IRC chat, other people just went across, found the other two maps Morse codes, put it together, and we got the answer. You see, there was one more keypad there, though. That actually has been confirmed by JJU to not be in effect yet. But we're going to be getting some more Easter eggs in the future, also confirmed by JJU. This being a Battlefield 4 game developer who we were going back and forth with the entire time we were trying to figure this out. He was the one that said, this is going to be found within the game. It's just going to be, as you're playing the game, you're going to find it. Hence, it's in my hands today, and hopefully in yours very soon. The mystery does not end there, however, because we still don't have the Phantom Operative mission complete. In fact, it's not even checked off to begin working on the Phantom Operative mission. The last thing we saw was physical access denied. We managed to get past that physical access point, get the bow, but what is going to trigger this final Phantom Operative mission? There has been some screenshots put out saying that once you get it, it's 200 kills and 50 headshots with this Phantom bow. Well, we have the bow, but the operative hasn't started. We also still don't have this final dog tag, this black and white dog tag with a blue eye in it. Where could that be from? Could it be the last door? We'll have to see. Stay tuned for more, guys. I'm gonna be on this. Subscribe if you are new. Again, thumbs up the video if this helped you guys out. At least you could get the bow for now. Huge step forward, and I wanted to wait until we got it, until I actually posted this out and the streams before, you could check those out. But click the previous video if you wanna see those, or click the recommended video to see my YOLO on the battlefield, which is an absolutely insane series. If you guys are new, this is one of my favorite episodes. Not my legendary 10th episode, but another one of my favorites. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. This is Stonemount64, signing out.